Hi guys, and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to set up Bukkit. This is going to be build 502 that I have here. So the first thing you're going to do is download the zip file that's in the description. When you download that, you'll open it up and you'll see this little message, maybe, if you have WinRAR. And you'll also see this folder. What you're going to want to do is drag this folder onto your desktop or wherever you want to run your server from. I already have it, so I'm not going to do that. Then what you're going to want to do is open this up, and we're going to go through each of the things that you need to do. So the first thing I would recommend is install this. This is Notepad++. This will help you editing a lot of the files. If you don't download this, there's a good chance you'll corrupt the files by editing it with Notepad or editing it with WordPad. So definitely download this and install it. I already have it installed, so I'm not going to worry about it. Then what you're going to want to do is open up your ops.txt and go ahead and remove my name from there and add your name. Okay, so that's your name. You put that in there and save it and close it out. Server log, go ahead and leave that alone in these two. Open up server.properties and then change what you want to change. Hell world, so this will make you spawn in the nether. Keep that false for most servers. Spawn monsters equals false or true if you want mobs to spawn, so like creepers and skeletons, whatever. I'm going to leave it false just for the sake of the video. Online mode equals true, make sure this is true. Spawn animals equals false. That's what you're going to want to do. Max players 20. That's, you know, pretty self-explanatory, most of this is, but player versus player, false. So that means players can hurt each other, yes or no. I don't want that, so I set it to false. Server port 25565, keep it at that unless you know what you're doing. Whitelist, so you can set this to true or false, with whatever you want. I'm going to set it to true for the sake of this video, but you're going to want to keep yours false under most situations. And then spawn protection, you can make this larger or smaller. I wouldn't recommend going over 32. But this is how many blocks away from spawn a regular user can't edit. So I keep it at zero, and I save it. And then you're going to see a bunch of these bat files, 512 to 4096. Actually, you know what? Edit your whitelist if you created one. I'm going to add myself before I forget, and then save it and close it out. Then you're going to see all these files. Now, what I would recommend is start with the biggest one and double-click it. And you see it says, okay, you can't actually run that. So click Enter. Okay, so that one didn't work, so now I'm going to try 2048. All right, well, that one didn't work either. So now I'm going to go to 1024. That one should work for most people. If it doesn't work for you, then you can go to 512. But if you do have that problem, your server's probably going to run a little slow. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and start it up, and you see it generated the world, and then it had all these plugins came up. Okay, so what we're going to do is type stop, just like that, into the command line, and then once it says press any key, press enter or space or whatever you want to do. Then what we're going to do is open up the plugins folder, and you'll see we have a bunch of jar files here, and we have two folders. What you're going to want to do is open up the essentials folder, and then open up the config.yml, right click it, don't open it like this, you want to click edit with Notepad++. If you decided not to install it, I'll show you. You can open it with WordPad. But the problem is, if you don't edit it correctly, you'll corrupt the file. So I definitely recommend editing it with Notepad++. And you can actually see it tells you whether something is incorrect or not based on the color. But what you want to do is go through this and read it. I'm not going to go through everything. It's pretty self-explanatory. It has these, and then if it doesn't explain it well enough just by the name, then you can read the note that's above it. Okay, so I'm just going to let you guys edit that. And let me see, I think there was maybe one thing. Nope, that's it. So yeah, just edit that, and I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next part of the video, because that would have taken me a long time to complete that. User data, you don't want to really mess with this. It's blank, but you don't really want to mess with it. You can delete my name out of there if it makes you feel better. It doesn't really matter if it's in there or not. And go ahead and exit out of that folder and open up the Essentials Group Manager folder. Now in this folder you're going to see a few folders. The only thing we're really worried about is config.yml. We're going to edit that. Actually, I lied. That's not what we're worried about. What you're going to want to do is open up Worlds and then World. Okay. And then what you're going to want to do is edit the users.yml. Now you can also edit the groups, but I'm not really sure on how all that works, so I'm not going to mess with it at all. So now you'll see users, and then you'll see the username, and then the group, or the permissions, the group they're in, info, so prefix and suffix. Anyway, what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and show you how to create a new user. So you're going to press enter at the end of here, and backspace all the way until you get flush with that line, okay? Then what you're going to want to do is press space three times, or two times, actually. Two times. So press space two times. Don't use tab, because tab will break the file. Then you're going to want to type in a username, so I'm going to go ahead and type in, I don't even know, chaos, okay? And you're going to put a colon at the end. Now, if it turns red when you do that, then you did something wrong, okay? So most likely what you did is you pressed tab and then you typed, you see how it's red? You have to make sure it's all spaces. So chaos, and then we're going to press enter, and we're going to press space, space again, and permissions. You see it's black until I put the colon at the end, okay? You're going to put these two things at the end there. Oops. Maybe not. Okay, so I guess leave those blank. I don't know, that's kind of weird. Okay. That's strange. Nope. Okay, so just leave that blank then. Press enter. Now, if you want to add a permission, you put a minus sign. Okay, you see how it's red. So I have to backspace and then use, oops, that was a tab. Then use spaces and then to dash space, and then maybe I want essentials dot star. Alright. And then press enter again, and if I start typing it's red, so you gotta backspace, delete that tab and replace it with spaces. Group, so group colon, okay. Admins, that's what we'll create it. I don't think capitalization really matters. If you do run into problems, try capitalizing things where they should be, but I don't think it really matters. Then go ahead and press enter, backspace, replace it with spaces. Info. Okay. Now I'm going to explain what this is. Okay, so we got our info, and what we're going to do is prefix. And what that is whatever comes before the name. For example, and C is actually a color. If we were to type and C in there, it would give whatever color C is. I think it's red. I'm not quite sure. I know and zero, I'm almost positive and zero is black. So if that person were to log in, their name would be black in chat. So I'm just going to keep it and C because I do know that that's red. So where the hell is the and sign? I never use it. And C. Okay, just like that. Okay, go ahead and press enter again. Now if you type... See, every time you do this, you need to make sure that it's spaces. Oops. Ugh. Okay, prefix and then suffix, of course, comes after the name. Suffix, like that. Okay, and then this is whatever comes after the name. So if you were to say, I don't even know, admin, you could put that and that would come after their name. You could put whatever you want. I don't really know of any examples, but that basically would come after their name when they say something in chat. So whatever, I'm gonna leave it blank. But that's pretty much how to edit that. To save when you're in Notepad++, you can press Control S, or there's an icon up here somewhere, this one right here, will save. Since I already saved, it's gone. And the best thing to do when you're done editing all these is go up here and press this little X right here. And if you notice, here, let me bring the window smaller. If you notice, when I press it, you know, the tabs start closing. Okay, and close all the tabs out and then close out Notepad. That's the best way to do it. Now the groups.yml, I'll go ahead and show you it, but I'm not going to edit it because I don't really see when it uses all these permissions, essentials.give, essentials.whatever. I don't really know what they are, but basically these are your four groups, or three groups. You have default, semi-admin, admin, and moderator. Okay, so you have four groups, and those are your groups. So basically, when you're editing that other file, those are the things you want to use in place of the groups. That's about it for that. Sorry I rambled on for so long about that. So go ahead and exit out of all that. Go back to here and launch that bat file you launched earlier. Now it'll launch and load everything up. And when it's done, it'll say done. If you want to know what version you're running, type /version. Oops, not slash. You don't want to put a slash. You put version in there. And then the server, blah, 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 502-GE, whatever, whatever, whatever. You can also type help, and it'll... Oops. Just type a question mark, I guess. Okay. And then it'll tell you a bunch of different things you can use. I'm just going to leave it how it is and save all. Okay. Alright. So now I've saved it. I'm going to go ahead and launch Minecraft to show you that everything works. And there will be another video teaching you how to use the in-game commands, but I'm not sure. Whoops. What you want to do is type in localhost. I will make another video showing you how to use all the in-game commands, but for now, I'm just showing you that it works. So if I type test, you can see my name is red, and that's because I had the and C, and I was also in the admins group. If you type /help, okay, so right now I'm on help page 1. If I wanted to get to help page 2, I'll type help, and then see how it says 1 of 13 right here? You're going to want to type /help 2, and that'll get you to page 2, and then you'll see page 2 of 13. Yep. So, give 1,000. If I were to type that, it gives me 1,000 stone. You know, it's pretty simple to get used to the commands. Yeah, I don't really know what else to say about it. I will make another video sometime in the future. I don't know if I'll make it today or tomorrow, or next week, or when I'm going to make it. But I will make another video on how to use the in-game commands. But for now, this should get you started on your server. You shouldn't have any problems. If you do, go ahead and send me a message on YouTube, or you can send me a message on Twitter or on Skype. You can go ahead and call me on Skype. Actually, I shouldn't say that. Don't call me on Skype unless I'm, you know, willing. So just go ahead and message me on Skype and, you know, see what's up. The links to all that is below in the description, as well as the link to the this zip file. So if you need any of that, that's where it's at. So yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching. I hope this helped you guys out. And yeah, so that's, I feel like I need to say something else, but I don't. So that's about the end of the video. I'll talk to you guys later.